والسلام على رسول الله وعلى جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. We continue our theme, دروس الحياة من قصص الأنبياء في كتاب الله. Life lessons from the stories of the prophets in the book of Allah. The Ahqaf are the long and winding tracks of wind-curved sand hills in what is the southern western part of the Arabian Peninsula. It's a desert part of the world. It's called Rub' al-Khali, the empty quarter, which is now uninhabited. And this is purported to be the land of Ad, to whom Nabi Hud alayhi salam was sent. And Allah mentions this, وَذْكُرْ أَخَا عَاد إِذْ أَنذَرَ قَوْمَهُ بِالْأَحْقَافِ وَقَدْ خَلَتِ النُّذُرُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Remember when Hud is the biblical prophet Eber, Hud alayhi salam, remember him when he came to the people of Ad, he was a brother to them, he was one of them, who noted that previous admonitions had already come to his people, and he warned his people who were living among these sand dunes to worship none but Allah. People of Ad lived many years in these windswept sand dunes between what is now Yemen and Oman, and they were known to be athletic people, renowned for their craftsmanship, especially in the construction of tall buildings in architecture and buildings with tall towers. Their capital was believed to be, as the Quran mentions, Iram Adat al-Imad, Iram, the city with many high pillars, and Allah knows best. But they were outstanding people of their time in architecture, power, in wealth, which unfortunately made them to be an arrogant people, and they used to boast that no one was stronger than them. Allah documents that also in Surah Fussilat, فَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ وَقَالُوا مَنْ أَشَدُّ مِنَّا قُوَّةٌ أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ الَّذِي خَلَقَهُمْ هُوَ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُمْ قُوَّةٌ. The people of Ad behaved arrogantly through the land beyond any justification. And they used to say, who is superior to us in strength? Did they not see that Allah who created them surely is more powerful than them? Lesson number one. Sometimes people become so overcome by their own importance that they do not realize the source of all their bounties and their favors. Their arrogance blinds them to the reality of the situation. And the vice of arrogance is the product of self-hype that makes a person overvalue himself and sometimes underestimate the value of others. And as the Rasul said in the hadith documented in the Sahih of Imam Muslim, Al-kibru batr al-haq wa ghamtu an-nas. Arrogance is being unmindful of the reality and looking down upon others. Therefore, as people of Iman, we say Alhamdulillah after the completion or the accomplishment of any achievement. Why? Because it is an acknowledgement that all praise and all thanks is to the one who created for us the capacity and the facility for us to do what we have done or to achieve what we have achieved. The narrative continues. وَلَقَدْ مَكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي مَا إِمْ مَكَّنَّاكُمْ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُمْ سَمْعُ أَبْصَارًا وَأَفْئِدَةً فَمَا أَغْنَى عَنْهُمْ سَمْعُهُمْ وَلَا أَبْصَارُهُمْ وَلَا أَفْئِدَتُهُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِذْ كَانُوا يَجْحَدُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَحَاقَ بِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ يَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. We have established the earth securely in a manner in which we have not established your people, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we have endowed them with the capacity for hearing and sight and knowledgeable hearts, and neither their hearing nor their sight nor their hearts avail them, seeing that they were on rejecting Allah's message despite all the facilities that they had, and in the end they were overwhelmed by the very thing which they mocked. They expected some kind of rain to come, the cloud, and eventually it was not rain, it was a storm. Do not be heedless. We are all aware that there are none so blind as those who refuse to see. And Allah warns us against such kind of ghafla or heedlessness. In another verse in the Quran, Allah says, وَلَقَدْ ذَرَأْنَا لِجَهَنَّمَ كَثِيرٌ مِّنَ الْجِنِّ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ أَذْنٌ يَسْمَعُونَ. يسمعون بي أولئك كالعام أولئك هم الغافلون. And certainly Allah has destined for the hellfire among human beings those perceive they feel not. They have eyes which they can see but they realize not what they see. They have ears which you can hear but listen. They are like animals, like cattle. In fact, they are worse because having the capacity and the ability, they choose to be heedless. From the present condition of Al-Ahqaf, the uninhabited winds and hills, no one can imagine, if you go there, you see it, that this land might have been the home of mighty people, boasting of some civilization, certainly ahead of their times. It was green, fertile, and then the change might have turned it into a sandy day. It is an arid wasteland. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in Surah Al-Nahl, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةِ الرَّسُولِ أَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَجَتَنِبُ الطَّاغُوتِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ هَدَى اللَّهُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ حَقَتْ عَلَيْهِ الضَّلَالَةِ فَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ انظروا كيف كان عاقب المكذبين. Indeed, within every community, to every community, Allah sent an apostle. Every community, Allah has sent. The message was, worship Allah and shun all forms of evil and corruption. And among these generations were people whom Allah graced that they received guidance. Just as there were among them many who inevitably fell prey together. So go about the earth, go to the earth. See what was the end result of those who belied truth. Lesson number three. The story of Hud with the people of Ad is a prime example of how civilizations may grow. Haughty, proud, by the achievements, by the buildings, by the heights. And then they are brought down. Why those who heed the advice? Man dakhala al-ujub alak. Remember, who overcomes his own self-importance, or those who come with their own arrogance, they are destined to destruction. May Allah protect us. May we heed the lessons we learn from the lives of these prophets. One, a model of excellence. We imbibe, inshallah, the characteristics and of gratitude. And that of arrogance and ingratitude. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.